Now she has the light.
Keep going. Save the light.
Keep going. The beast is down there.
No.
She knows the beast is down there.
He's always watching you.
The
beast is there. You're never safe from him.
You can feel him. She needs to find Ilya.
Where is he?
She needs to find it. She lost it and she has to fight it.
I can feel it. Where is it?
The torch, a light.
Can you see?
Where is she?
Stop heat. Where
is she?
Keep your eyes up. You're never going to find it. Do it. They're too strong.
she wouldn't listen.
He was doing his best. She never, ever listens.
Why didn't she listen to him? He was trying to help her. He was trying to save her from the darkness.
Zimbel was right.
Zimbel was trying to save her from the darkness. But she wouldn't listen.
She never choose.
And now everybody is dead.
Because of her.
It's all her fault.
All her fault.
She's weak. So weak. She should have known. She should have thought.
Why doesn't she learn? Will she learn?
She doesn't understand.
Now the darkness has Dillian's soul.
And it will take it and never give it back.
She can search and search, but she...
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure. Although Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Thank you.
she doing?
She's lighting the torch.
She's making light. She's making a fire.
She's got light on the other side.
She'll be safe.
What's her plan?
What's she thinking? She got to get there.
So.
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak, and they say, Sigurd should eat the heart himself. Rian wants Fafnir's gold. Sigurd should kill Rian before Rian kills him. Sigurd should find Brynhild the Valkyrie, who sleeps an enchanted sleep. Sigurd heeds the bird's advice. He kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest to ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild the Valkyrie.
Capable one. Remember your training.
Get up quick!
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shadow, listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. At every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
And take me to the mountain
to trust him.
As deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.
I know.
What else can she do?
She's there.
I won't let the darkness trick me again. I know you're safe with the gods. I can feel Hela's gaze, searching for secrets inside of me. Secrets that even I can't see. I'm not here to fight my past. I'm here for Dilya. I will fulfill my vow, whatever the cost.